All right, how exciting is this? So far, the build-up is moving along very, very nicely. Out here on the bull bar, we've got the ultimate 225 driving lights that will do a fantastic job of lighting that nighttime four-wheel driving. We've got a big hole here ready and waiting for a winch. Now, as you've seen, Mark likes to get out there on those tracks, and he's certainly been having a lot of fun, but he has been getting stuck quite a bit. Tires will go a long way to improving his off-road traction, and all of the things we've done to this vehicle will help. But a winch is off-road insurance. When everything fails, the winch will be there to help pull him out of any problems and also to rescue anybody else who's travelling with him. Now, we had a choice of a number of winches. We could have gone for the top-of-the-range worn winch at around $2,500. We could have gone for something like a super winch, a fantastic product at around $1,700 to $1,800. But based on price alone and at well under $600, we've opted for this budget build-up for the Tigerz11 4x4 winch, which will certainly do the job for Mark out there on the tracks. Now, as you've seen, we've installed a lot of winches here on 4WD TV, so getting this into the vehicle is no drama at all, and it's going to be an awesome unit. Now, depending on the design of your bull bar, you may need to pre-drill your roller fairlead. In this case, the lower mounts for the winch are lower on the mouth of the bull bar itself, so we've had to drill some lower mounts on the fairlead. With the winch installed and the wiring complete, a quick test ensures that it's all working properly and allows us to preload the winch cable. The tough bit now is to go out bush in search of the best winch test of all, deep sticky mud.